Well, good evening, everybody, and happy Shrove Tuesday, or happy Ash Wednesday Eve, as it may be. It is great to see you all here, and as always, thank you so much for coming. I'm going to engage in a little bit of advertising before we get started with Dr. Michener's recital this evening. This is the third and final recital of the year in the 2022-23 Harkness Organ Series. We are already at work on next year's series. I'm not at liberty to divulge who the performers are, but you can probably figure out who one of them is, who might just be playing an all-Bach recital next March 21st. But we have some really interesting things planned, great things planned, so we will let you know as soon as that is finalized. In the meantime, though, for the rest of this spring, I do want to call your attention to some wonderful organ, one wonderful organ recital, and then a Furman Singers concert that will be coming up with several razzmatazz organ anthems. The solo recital is by my senior student, Nolan Anthony, who's from Hendersonville, and he will be performing on March 21st, exactly a month from tonight. And he has a splendid program. I hope that you will be able to come to that. He's a wonderful player. And then Furman Singers will be going on tour this year to Texas, to San Antonio and Dallas, and I'm going along with them and playing. Nolan is doing some accompanying on that too. They will be back and classes starting the week of March 13th. I don't have the dates of the home concerts here, but I think they're a week later than they have been. One's on a Thursday, I think maybe the week of March 20th, 23rd? Okay, and then there's one on Sunday, too. Yeah. So we're doing, as I say, some really nice anthems for that and showing off this instrument in its accompanying capacity. So we hope that you can come to those as well. As always, before we begin tonight, please be sure that if you have anything electronic on you that might go boop or squawk or whatever, please be sure that, that you have turned that off. It is a special pleasure for me to welcome Dr. Jack Michener to the Harkness Organ. I have known Jack probably for longer than he knows, actually. I first heard him in a recital at the North Carolina School of the Arts when he was a senior, I think just graduating. This was in June of 1986, and I had just come down from Minnesota to look for a house here in Greenville because I was starting at Furman next fall. And he played on that occasion up in Winston-Salem the sixth trio sonata of Bach and didn't miss a note. And I thought, wow, this is really something. Over the years, our paths have crossed many times. He is a splendid player, and he has a wonderful program, Church Music and Organ, at Mercer University in Macon, where he is the organ professor and university organist. And in addition, he is also artist in residence at the Cathedral of St. Philip in Atlanta. And you can read all about his career. He has studied not only here in the United States, but abroad as well. And you are in for a real treat this evening. So without further ado, please help me welcome to the Harkness Organ, Dr. Jack Michener.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Charles, for that welcome. It's a delight to be here and to play this magnificent organ in this really wonderful space. Wanted to say a few things about the pieces on the first half of the program. All of this music is either from Germany or Holland, in the case of Svelink. The first piece is one that will give me a chance to really demonstrate a lot of the colors on this wonderful organ. And that's really what composers like Buxtehude intended. They had these magnificent instruments in northern Germany. Buxtehude lived in Lübeck, and they were very substantial instruments with lots of character and lots of color, just like this organ. So it's a very exciting piece, and you will hear loud sounds, soft sounds, faster sections, slower sections, so it sort of moves back and forth and is very dramatic. Following that is a set of variations, very gentle piece by Svelink. Svelink lived in Amsterdam and was really the most important musician in that city in his day, and this set of variations can be played on the harpsichord or the organ. I'll play it entirely on the division of pipes that are just above my head, called the positive division. And you'll hear an array of flutes and so forth. This tune was popular in the day, and Svelink was known for his extensive improvisations on tunes like this one. Following that, you have music of Bach. First, a short chorale prelude, and you have hymnals. If you're interested in following the melody and the text, this is a very short piece, but a sort of ornamented or embellished version of the melody of hymn 395. And following that is a really magnificent work of J.S. Bach. This is something he composed late in his life, and the prelude is rather extensive, shows the influence of composers like Vivaldi. It's a really wonderful piece. And then the fugue has a subject. I'll just play that subject so that you will recognize it. And it's called the wedge because you can hear how that melody sort of wedges out to an octave. So through the years, organists have given it that nickname. So hope you enjoy this music. I'd just like to say we'll take a short intermission, probably only about 5 minutes. So thank you. just like to say a few things about the pieces in the second half. First of all, the birth date for Margaret Sandresky is not a mistake. She is 101 and will celebrate her 102nd birthday on the 28th of April. So she's a good friend of mine. And what you will hear is the first three movements of this organ mass she wrote. The L'Homme Armé tune is something that goes back to the Crusades, but it was a tune that was used quite a lot in the medieval period, in the early Renaissance. And Margaret Sandresky, being a composer, organist, but also music theorist, was very interested in studying masses, choral mass, vocal masses from the Renaissance, and many were based on this tune, and that got her interested. So then she wrote this organ mass based on it. And you'll hear it from the first movement, which is very short, but you'll hear the tune right in the top voice, just embellished quite a bit with little scalar figures and so forth. But and then the very quiet Kyrie, the melody is played in the pedals. And then the Gloria is just a joyous, exciting work. And she has bits and pieces of the tune there. Following that, there are two spirituals by Adolphus Hailstork, both well known and show off the colors of the organ, so hope you enjoy those. And then finally, the final two movements from Louis Vierne's third organ symphony. And this organ is just made for this kind of music, and it's a lot of fun to play here. So I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Thank you. I'd just like to leave you with another work of Margaret Sandresky. This is a joyous march in A major, and this is Mardi Gras or Shrove Tuesday, so last chance to really celebrate. So I hope you enjoy this piece.